I'm Kevin Conaway. I'm the Program Director of the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology here at Marshall University. We have a small program. We take 3 residents a year. The size of our program, I think, is a benefit. There's a lot of camaraderie amongst the residents. There's a lot of individual attention with the faculty. We have 17 full-time faculty. We have 2 maternal fetal medicine specialists, 1 gynecologic oncologist, a reproductive endocrinologist, 2 urogynecologists, and a pediatric adolescent gynecologist. We also have a very active volunteer faculty, and the residents are involved in over 2,500 deliveries a year and many inpatient and outpatient gynecologic procedures. If you have interest in the program, contact us, send in your application materials, and we're happy to speak with you.
I'm originally from Southern California, and I interviewed all over the country because there wasn't one particular place that I wanted to go, and I ended up here at Marshall. It was my first choice, and it was a very good choice for me. West Virginia has a lot of high-risk pregnancies, so I was very well prepared in the 4 years that I was here to go out and practice, go on to fellowship, and it's just a very well-rounded education.
Number one, this is a great place to work. It's a hospitable environment. The work relationship between Marshall University and Cabell Huntington Hospital, where we do our inpatient work, is absolutely fabulous. And we actually run a medication-assisted therapy program out of the high-risk office. And residents are an integral part of taking care of those patients.
I'm a pediatric and adolescent gynecologist, which is kind of a unique subspecialty. I deal with gynecologic disorders in younger patients. So I see patients from birth with gynecologic issues up till, you know, late adolescence. So most of my patients in clinic are between the ages of 10 and 18, but I also see young kids that have gynecologic disorders. There's no obstetrics in my office, it's only gynecology, and so residents get exposed to a lot of different gynecologic disorders, very unique to younger patients. During 4 years of residency, you'll complete a project, and I help you along the way develop your IRB, develop the project details, complete your data collection, and then hopefully write a manuscript for publication.
We do establish a continuity of care with the residents, especially with the chief residents, as they spend a couple months with us, and they do go with us in clinic, they do see our patients, they take ownership of our patients and responsibilities, and then obviously they go with us to the operating room where they actually develop their and expand their surgical techniques. We're really happy with all the ancillary services that we have here in the hospital to be able to offer the best of care for patients with GYN malignancies and or complex gynecological problems.
We are able to turn out residents at the end of their chief year who are able to go out and be credentialed and practice robotic hysterectomies and robotic surgery at whatever institution that they're going to. And I don't think that's something that we're able to see nationwide. We have 3 robotic consoles and 2 of those have teaching consoles. So the residents from early on are able to get onto the teaching console. We obviously start with the computer-based activities and they learn what the pieces and parts of the robot and the console are. Then they proceed on to their dry docking labs where they learn how to dock the robot and how to be a bedside assistant. And then because we have the teaching consoles, they're able to get on the console early on. So I can sit at my surgical console and they can sit right beside me and we can pass instruments back and forth and I can show them exactly what I want them to do and they're able to learn those parts of the case. And we recently got a not for human use console, so they 24/7 have access to a surgical console where they can practice doing hysterectomies, where they can see films of the different parts of the hysterectomy, and we're also able to log their hours so that we can see them go from a novice surgeon to an experienced surgeon.
It's a fantastic program if you're looking for a tight-knit community in a small town with good people. You are hands-on right when you start. Intern year, you're doing C-sections. Pretty much your first week, you're doing hysteroscopies, laparoscopy, DNCs, pretty much your first week if you're on gynecology. We really do have fair work hours. We have a night float system, which works really well because it allows the day team to not have to be there for so long.
Thanks for taking a look at us here at the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology at Marshall School of Medicine. We think we have a lot to offer. Our faculty really do care about residents. We really do care about education, and we really do care about doing the right thing for all of our patients every time. We don't have fellows, so residents are responsible for managing the most complex problems that you'll encounter in obstetrics and gynecology. We've got an open door. Residents come in all the time and just say, hey, Dr. Jude, I've got an issue. I've got a question. I've got a problem. Can you help me with that? So please take a look at us. I think you'll find that we've got a very positive learning environment and a very solid residency program, and be happy to have you here in Huntington.